is raining so much outside.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. I am Atrey, and if you don't know, there is series going on my channel, 30 days of September and birthday edition, and my birthday is on 17th. So I am posting videos on every day of September. So make sure you like and subscribe my channel. Now without any further ado, let's get started. Now this video, this was a suggestion from one of my subscribers, so I thought of doing this particular video where I'm going to compare all of these highlighters, because if you don't know, K-Beauty launched a new highlighter in the market, and I have already done a separate review of this particular highlighter on my channel. You can go and check it. And I'm very sorry for the lighting quality because it is kind of dark outside, but I wanted to film this one, so here I am filming it. Now I bought this one. This launched very recently, I think 1 or 2 months ago, and this is the K-Beauty Illuminating Highlighter Sunlit Gold. And now I wanted it to compare with two of my staple favorites, that is the Maybelline Master Chrome Highlighter in the shade Molten Gold and Wet n Wild Precious Petal Highlighter. I also have the Rose Gold one by Maybelline, so I wanted to compare each and everything for you guys. Now coming to the K-Beauty highlighter, the packaging and everything is top notch. Like if we compare the packaging of this Wet n Wild and Maybelline, packaging is not good at all. But if you see, the packaging of this particular product is so good. Like it is, the mirror is so reflective, I can't even tell you. And this looks so sleek.
Also, but it retails for
899 rupees, if I'm not wrong, for 8.5 grams of product, and it is 100% vegan, cruelty free, and all of those good stuff. So yeah, this is this. And if we talk about Maybelline and Wet n Wild, so obviously the packaging is very flimsy, you can see. And although they are much cheaper, and you can get your hands on these particular highlighters in sale season, and on K-Beauty also you get discount up to 20%. But price wise, if I feel that it is a little bit expensive, it could have been somewhere around 600. So price wise, these are much better. Now coming to the quality of all of these highlighters. So if you see the K-Beauty one, it is like butter. They also have 6 shades in this particular range. So if you see this, so I feel that this particular highlighter, it's not at all bam. It is very neutral, I'll say. So it is not going to give you the whole lit up kind of face. Like I am wearing this on my face today, I don't know if you can see this, but it just gives a natural glow on your face. It is not very chunky, it is very very soft, very finely milled, and yeah, this is what it looks like. I love this because if you're someone who likes to apply very less highlighter, so you are going to love this like me. But if you're someone who likes BAM highlighter, so this is not your jam, because this is not BAM according to me. Now coming to the Maybelline Master Chrome one, if you see this, so this is what I call highlighter which is very on your face, and this is so soft to touch. So this is very creamy. I feel that the texture is very wet to dry, and in fact if you talk about this, the texture is dry. But this is wet to dry. It appears as if it has been pressed in this particular packaging, and then we are using it. So yeah, you can see this. Now I am swatching it right here. Now there is a color. There is a difference of color. If you can see, this is more on goldeny type of color, and this is a warm gold type color. This is more towards lemony yellow. Yeah. Again, this is also very soft to touch, soft to blend, and both of them are not chalky. So this is very BAM. So let me apply this on my face and you will get to know what I'm talking about. So the lighting is very bad today. I don't know if you're able to see, but when I apply this, this just makes my face glow. But then it can look over the top if you overdo it, while if you, in fact, even if you you know layer this one, this will not make your face cakey or it will not look overly done. But yeah, that is about it. Also, in Maybelline one, there are no chunky particles or shimmer particles. Now coming to the Wet n Wild one, and this is how it looks like. The packaging on this one is slightly better than the Maybelline one, because Maybelline one is a little bit flimsy, and the pattern and everything is also very good. Now it is also very very soft to touch. Now this highlighter and this highlighter, I feel that there is a similarity. First of all, let me swatch this. Okay, this is the Wet n Wild one. So this is the Wet n Wild one, and this is in the shade Rose Gold. So the texture of rose, this one, Wet n Wild one, and K Beauty one, I think both of them are pretty similar. If we talk about the texture, so let me just place this. You can see. So when I touch them, na, I feel both feels very very similar to me. The only thing is what I feel is that it is more of powdery texture, while this again is very very soft to touch. So that is it. Now what will I recommend you to you guys? Now this is a little bit expensive, so if you can't spend that much of money and you like the soft glow, so what you can do is you can go and buy this one. This is the Wet n Wild Precious Petals Highlighter. There are tons of shade. You can choose whatever shade you feel like. Now if you're someone who like to glow like bulb, so you can definitely go and you know buy this one. Now the moment of truth, I think my favorite till date has to be the Maybelline one, because it is really good, really awesome, affordable. So out of these three, if you really want to buy any highlighter, go and buy the Maybelline one. Yeah, but that doesn't mean that I don't like the K-Beauty one. I like it equally, but then price wise, everything wise, I think that this is worth it. Now let me also give you the swatch of this one. This is the same Maybelline one, but then it is in the shade Rose Gold, and this is how it is. This one is Rose Gold. So the shade Precious Petals and Rose Gold is very similar. What I also feel that I do not contain a shade which is similar to the K Beauty one. So that's why I like the K Beauty one, because the color is pretty different, and I don't own any color like this. Okay guys, that was about it. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know in the comment section how do you guys like it. Prices and everything will be mentioned in the bottom bar, also on the screen. So please feel free to ask anything you feel like. Now yeah, that's about it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you guys in my next video. You guys take care.